Welcome back. The movie Silver Linings Playbook is about dealing with mental illness in the family, and it's something many people, as we've heard today, can relate to, including former Congressman Patrick Kennedy, the son of the late Senator Ted Kennedy, and nephew, of course, of President John F. Kennedy. Patrick, welcome. Thank you for coming by today.
Thank you, Katie.
Really appreciate it. You have been very, very open about your struggles with depression and bipolar disorder. Tell me how that's affected your life.
Well, first of all, I didn't have much of a choice about whether to be open, because when I got ill, it was on the front page of all the newspapers. If I had had diabetes and went out and had 3 pieces of chocolate cake, the press wouldn't have asked me about it. But if I was self-medicating because I had a couple of shots at the bar that I was trying to hide, that was fodder, because we look at mental illness as a character flaw, not as a chemistry issue of the brain. And what we hope to do in the years ahead through more research is understand that behavior is a symptom of neuroscience. So when the brain isn't firing right, you act out. And that's the nature of us fearing mental health. But we need to have a dialogue about this. And I really salute the cast and the whole crew for this movie, because it helps introduce that dialogue to the American public.
You know, everybody hears the term bipolar disorder, but I think people still really don't understand it. And I think part of our efforts to help people is to explain things. So what exactly is bipolar disorder, Patrick?
Well, broadly speaking, bipolar is otherwise described as manic depressive. So you have manic episodes where your mood is elevated, very euphoric, and then you have depressive episodes where you're really down in the dumps, and no matter what's going on in your life, the way you look at it is through that set of eyeglasses of everything's bleak and irreparable and I can't do anything in my life productive. And you can make a lot of self-destructive decisions when you're in those, either one of those episodes, because you either are making the decision based upon a false sense of the world around you when you're euphoric, or a false sense.
Until we have people talk about this, which is what this movie helps us begin to do,
and gain a level of acceptance, people are still not going to avail themselves of treatment, even if it's provided. And the treatment itself will not be what we want it to be, because no one's going to Washington, D.C. and advocating for mental health treatment. By the way, Congress is not going to do this alone. We need to tell them, listen, we care about this, and we're going to watch how you vote.